To show that a problem is PSPACE complete, we follow the same general strategy that we were following when we were trying to establish that a problem is NP complete. To show that a problem X is PSPACE complete, we first show that X is contained in PSPACE so that the problem can be solved in polynomial space. The second step is that we take some problem which we already know to be PSPACE complete and we reduce it to this problem X in polynomial time in a cup reduction. As an example, we now demonstrate this using the problem competitive facility location. So we want to show that competitive facility location is PSPACE complete. The first step is to show that competitive facility location can be solved in polynomial space. This works exactly the same as showing that quantified satisfiability can be solved in polynomial space. We use the same general algorithm. The only difference is that for quantified satisfiability, at each step, a player only has two choices. The player can choose to set a variable to true or to false. In competitive facility location, a player has many more choices because we have a graph that has n nodes that a player can choose from. So potentially a player has n choices in each step rather than just two. But that is really the only difference. So rather than a binary tree, we get an n-ary tree. And we just can solve it in basically the same way as quantified satisfiability. To show that competitive facility location is PSPACE complete, we have to reduce a problem to it that we already know to be PSPACE complete. So far, we've only learned about a single problem that is PSPACE complete, and that was QSAT. So that is a problem we will use for our reduction. Given an instance of QSAT, we construct an instance of competitive facility location such that the second player can force a win if and only if the quantified Boolean formula is false. Given a Boolean CNF formula, we construct a graph in the following way. For each variable in the Boolean formula, we create two nodes in the graph. And we connect those two nodes by an edge. So we have one node corresponding to the first variable x1, and then we have a second node which will correspond to the negation of that variable. So the second node is a stand-in for not x1. And we have the same for x2 and not x2. And again, we connect the two by an edge. And so on up to variable xn and not xn. The idea here is that the players will be able to choose these vertices and that they will not be able to choose for a variable, both the variable itself and its negation, because they are connected by an edge, so competitive facility location does not allow both endpoints of that edge to be chosen. Now, in quantified satisfiability, the variables are chosen in a very specific order. First, the first player chooses a value for the variable x1, and then the second player chooses a value for the variable x2, and then the first player chooses a value for the variable x3. We want to mirror this thing in our input for competitive facility location. So somehow we want to enforce that the first player first picks either x1 or not x1, and the second player then picks either x2 or not x2, and so on. And the question is, how can we enforce this? We cannot strictly enforce this, but we can make it such that that is the only reasonable thing for the players to do. And we do this by simply assigning very large values to the nodes associated with the variable x1 and not x1, and slightly smaller values to the variables x2 and not x2, and so on, and the smallest values to the nodes corresponding to the variables xn and not xn. So because the variables x1 and not x1, the nodes that correspond to those variables, are so much more valuable than everything else, it makes no sense for a player to start picking something else first. So if you are the first player, you go for the most valuable vertices first. Specifically, we choose a large constant c, and we assign a value of c to the power n to x1 and not x1. And then we assign a value of c to the power of n minus 1 to x2 and not x2, and so on, all the way down to a value of c for the nodes that correspond to the variables xn and not xn. I believe it as an exercise to really verify that this ensures that the only plausible thing a player can do is to pick the values for these variables in this order. So the first player really picks either x1 or not x1 first, if they want to have any hope in winning this game. For competitive facility location, we also have to specify what our threshold target profit is. So the first player wants to prevent the second player from getting at least B units of profit. So what is this value of B? And we choose B here as being equal to C to the n minus 1 plus C to the n minus 3 plus C to the n minus 5 and so on, all the way down to plus C squared and then plus 1. And the reason for doing this is that if the players pick these nodes in the order we discussed, then the profit that player 2 will get so far is exactly this: c to the power of n minus 1 plus c to the power of n minus 3 plus c to the power of n minus 5 and so on down to plus c squared. The only thing missing here is an additional profit of plus 1. Okay, so the second player almost gets the profit he or she needs, but it misses a single unit of profit. So far, we've not used the Boolean formula at all, apart from the number of variables contained in that formula. But we have not looked at the clauses that this formula contains. Therefore, we now further amend this graph that we constructed so far, and we add additional nodes to it and additional edges. We will do this in such a way that player 2 can win the game and get this additional profit of 1 that the player is so far missing, if and only if a tooth assignment defined by the chosen values for the variables. So if we choose the node that corresponds to variable x1, we set the variable to true. And if we choose the node that corresponds to not x1, we would set the variable to false. So if this assignment that we get in this way fails to satisfy some clause, then we will give player 2 an opportunity to get the one missing unit of profit that he or she needs to win the game. Suppose the formula contains a clause of the form x1 or x2 or not xn. So what can we do? We create an additional node in the graph for that clause, and the weight of that node will be 1, enabling player 2 an additional profit of 1 if he or she can pick that node. But we are going to connect this node to, in this case, the node that corresponds to the variable x1 and the variable x2 and the node that corresponds to the variable not xn. Now, player 2 can only select this node of value 1 if none of the neighbors have been chosen before. So the player can only choose this if the first player picked not x1, the second player picks the node corresponding to not x2, and the first player in the end also picks the node corresponding to the variable xn. Meaning, we would think about this in a truth assignment way of saying x1 is false, x2 is false, and xn is true. And if this happens, this clause x1 or x2 or not xn is not satisfied yet. And we can see that now the second player can actually pick this node because none of the neighbors have been chosen. However, if the clause x1 or x2 or not xn is satisfied by the assignment that arises out of the nodes that have been picked so far by the two players, then it is not possible for player 2 to pick this node of weight 1. This is because in that case, we would have to either have picked x1 or x2 or not xn. And all three of these are neighbors of this particular clause. So all three of these, if we pick any of them before, we cannot pick this node of weight 1 anymore. That is the entire construction. We increase the size of the graph slightly. We add an additional node for every clause in the formula, and we connect it to the nodes we had before in the way described. This is a very simple construction. It can be done in polynomial time. And I hope it's clear that also this construction satisfies the requirement we have that there is a way for player 2 to win this game if and only if the quantified Boolean formula is false. And therefore, the first player will win this game if and only if the quantified Boolean formula is true, which is exactly the property we needed.